We just got the first developer beta of iOS 17.4, and this is a massive update. Not only is Apple Podcasts getting native transcript support, the App Store is going to have massive changes in the EU, cloud gaming apps are going to be allowed in the App Store globally, better controls for stolen device protection, and maybe most important of all, new emojis too. First up is transcripts in Apple Podcasts. This is a big deal. Not only is Apple offering to transcribe your audio and offer that in the player without you having to do anything, you can also upload transcripts from your podcast hosting provider, and those transcripts will be viewable right here in the player. Not only that, but it's going to highlight the words as they go by as the podcast is playing. You can also search the transcript of the podcast right here in the player. It'll show you all the search results for that word. You can scroll through them with the up and down arrows. And if someone would prefer just to read the entire transcript without playing the audio, you can hit the three dots and then view transcript. And the entire transcript is here, and you can read it and also search it using the magnifying glass up at the top. On the dashboard side, if you have a podcast in Apple Podcasts, you can go to your show page and then go down to availability. You'll now see a new transcriptions area, and you can choose to only display the auto-generated transcripts by Apple, or if you plan to provide them yourself through a podcast host, you can choose to display the transcripts you provide, and if they're not provided, you can allow Apple to auto-generate those transcripts by selecting this option. Also, when you go to a specific episode of your podcast, you can scroll down to where you have the audio and transcripts area, and if you click the free RSS version, you'll see the option for a transcript. If you provided a transcript, you can see it here through your podcast host, or you can access the auto-generated transcript from Apple Podcasts. You can also change the default setting you set for the show just for this specific episode. And anytime you're listening to a podcast, you'll see the same symbol that looks like the lyric symbol in Apple Music, and when you tap that, it'll bring up the transcript, you'll see the highlighted words, and the entire transcript is here. Also, if you tap in the transcript, it'll jump to that portion of the audio in the podcast. And this should not affect any of the chapters you might already have as a part of your show. Next up is changes to stolen device protection. If you go to your settings app and then go down to Face ID and Passcode, this is where the stolen device protection settings live. Now, if you scroll down, you'll see the stolen device protection. I have it turned on here. But if you tap that setting, you'll now get more options. This is the new setting for 17.4. If you want to always require that biometric authentication like Face ID or Touch ID, even if you're at one of your quote-unquote familiar locations, you can change this to always, and now no matter where you are, it will always require that Face ID or Touch ID to change settings, and it'll have that 60-minute delay if you want to turn off stolen device protection. The familiar and significant locations is still a little different. I've talked about on the podcast primary technology. If you go to your privacy and security and then location services, you can go to System Services, scroll all the way down, and then Significant Locations. It's a little bit unclear whether or not stolen device protection is accessing these records or if it's somewhere else like your quote-unquote frequent locations. But it's nice to see this additional setting here for stolen device protection. And remember, this is the first developer beta, and so it's going to be a number of weeks, even a couple months, before you see 17.4 on your devices. Run betas at your own risk. There will be a public beta available as well coming soon. As far as new emojis, we got these two faces, a lime, mushroom, broken chain, and what I'm going to believe is a firebird. I'm taking that as an homage to Stravinsky. But I'm also going to select all these, and let's see what Siri calls them.
Head shaking horizontally, head shaking vertically, lime, brown mushroom, broken chain, phoenix.
Ah, the phoenix. All right, so more X-Men than Stravinsky, but still pretty cool. So the other big changes in 17.4, a lot of them are going to take place for the European Union specifically. For the first time, Apple is going to allow different browser engines in the European Union with 17.4. Even if you were running Chrome or Microsoft Edge apps on your iPhone and iPad right now, it's actually using the same browser engine called WebKit that Safari uses. So websites and pages are going to look exactly the same. If you have an issue with a website in Safari, it would be the same in Chrome or Microsoft Edge in those apps. But with this new ruling, different browser engines like Chrome on the desktop will be allowed in the EU. Again, this is EU only. We will not see these kind of different browser engines here in the US, at least not right now. And the other big change is that Apple is going to allow alternative app stores in the European Union with 17.4. That means there'll be different marketplaces in addition to the App Store where you can download apps outside of the App Store. There'll be new frameworks and APIs for this, and there'll even be different payment processing options for developers in the EU. Apple also said there's going to be a reduced commission structure. Those terms will be set at 17% plus 3% if apps are using Apple's in-app purchase system. This is significantly down from the old 30% rate. And app makers will be able to use different payment processors in their apps. Again, all of this is just EU only. But all the talk of sideloading that you have heard for years, this is it. In the EU, it's going to happen in 17.4. In addition to the App Store on your iPhone, you'll be able to go to a website, some developer's website or a marketplace, download an app directly to your iPhone, not from the App Store, and then from in that marketplace app on your phone, that's not the App Store, you'll be able to download other apps that developers can make for sale right there and never put in the App Store at all. This is literally sideloading. Remains to be seen what this means. Apple in their newsroom article stated that this is obviously to comply with the EU laws. There is still going to be notarization for iOS apps, and this is going to apply regardless of the distribution channel. So even apps you get from alternative marketplaces will need to be notarized by iOS. And Apple has made it clear that installing applications in this way with third-party app marketplaces, that Apple has less ability to address risks like scams, fraud, abuse, and possibly other harmful content. I'll put a link to this Apple Newsroom article down in the video description, but this is a huge change. Now, something that's going to affect iPhone and iPad users worldwide, this is not just the EU, is that Apple is also going to allow game streaming apps on the App Store for the first time natively worldwide. This is the United States, EU, everywhere. That means things like xCloud Gaming, which you would need to go to the website and then add that icon to your home screen. You won't have to do that anymore. Xbox can release a native iOS app in the App Store, and all the cloud games that you could play previously just kind of in the web browser, you'll actually be able to play in the native xCloud Gaming app on your iPhone or iPad. These are all massive updates to a 17.4 release before we're even getting Apple Vision Pro next week as we record. So subscribe to the channel and stay tuned if there's any changes in future betas or when the public release comes. I'll be doing videos on all of that. These are awesome changes, though, for Apple Podcasts. Having those native transcripts, even Apple transcribing it for you, is great. New emojis is always fun. And these changes in the EU is going to make for a wave of third-party apps outside the App Store, and we're going to see what that means. Don't forget to hit that like button before you go. I'm also going to put two videos right up here. This is 15 tips on how to manage text on your iPhone. If you don't learn something, I promise you can have your money back. And I'm also going to put a playlist here. I'm adding new shortcuts videos all the time. And if you want to start from the very beginning and learn shortcuts like 101, 7 easy ones to start with, check out that playlist. I think you'll enjoy it. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.